Hi friends, welcome to Cloud ML. This is Akash. So today I will be explaining on the SQL questions which are being asked in data science interviews. So I am currently facing many interviews. So there are many questions they will ask, tricky questions related to SQL. So I found a question on HackerRank which very well compensates, like it consists of applying many concepts based on which interviewers will ask you questions. So I will try to give a solution for that question. It will be quite interesting. Stay tuned and subscribe to my channel. So this is the problem statement. You need to click on this link. I will give it in this link in the description. So you just need to log in the HackerRank and open this link. So you can see they will give you a pop-up for login. Yeah, so you need to log in here, then you will be able to enter the problem statement. I'm closing this. So now coming to the problem statement. So this is a table called stations. We need to query two cities name. Fine. So whenever we start with SQL, my approach is like I will first see what are the things they want us to print. So it is the shortest length and longest name city names as well as their respective length. So my first line what I will write is this one: select city comma length from station, and whatever comes next I will think about them later. So this is the approach I follow. That is number of characters in the name. Okay, so if there are more than one small or larger city, then choose the one that comes when ordered alphabetically. So they have given the example also, it will become more clear. So we have these two examples. So suppose we have two cities, ABC and DEF. They are of same length, 3, but alphabetically it is coming first, so only this should get printed, and fourth here this should get printed because alphabetically it is coming first and the length is 4. So this is the expectation. So let's come to the coding part. So make sure it is a MySQL. I have written in MySQL. You can choose your own suitable environment. So next statement will be where length city equal to maximum length city. Now this statement, many of you might think that we can just write maximum length city. Why to write such whole query? But it won't work like that. So aggregate functions like max don't work in the where condition. So you need to write a whole sub query which will return a number which is just the maximum length of the city from the station. Then you need to order by the city. Remember, order by the alphabetical order and limit one. So if there may be many cities which are having same length, but we want the first city only, so it I will take is at limit one. Similarly, I will do a separate table for minimum length. Nothing has changed, just this function min has changed here. And same thing. So now I have two tables here and here. One for minimum length city, one for maximum length city. See, we can't do same condition check in one query. So we have to write two queries and we will join those query using the union statement. You can see the union function here. So like we can join two tables with same structure, one below other. And you can see here order by they have used as the last, but what we have done is order by we have done in the respective query. We can also do at the last, but the thing is that we won't get the desired results. We want order by to happen inside this table and separately inside this table. So that's why I have given the brackets also separately. Otherwise, I need not give bracket also, these two brackets. Fine. When you do the union and run the code, you can see the proper output will come. Yeah, so output sample test pass. Let's submit the code to check other test cases. Yeah, so all the test cases passed, hidden test case also, and we got the, I don't think there's some hidden test case, only one test case only. So we are done here. So this is one of like complex query which you can find on HackerEarth, and if you have understanding of the concepts used in this query, you can very well tackle most of the interview questions. Also, I am going to make different typical queries which I have faced in my interviews personally. Those SQL queries also I will be making separate videos. I will make a series of these. And yeah, if you have some particular query which you faced or you find difficult or you want me to explain, you can write in the comment box. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your time. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much.